Mike Panaki here with Network Protocol Specialists, LLC. And in this CCTT behind the scenes video, we're going to take a look at how we set launch and tail compensation on single mode fiber. Before we go in and we do any testing with the OptiFiber Pro with single mode fiber, it is really important that we set launch and tail compensation. And before I set launch and tail compensation, I inspect the ports on my test equipment. So here we can see what the test equipment looks like when we've got it all set up. Now, before connecting any of the fibers, I inspected the port on the OptiFiber Pro single mode port. And this is what it looked like. So it looked good. I didn't need to do anything. I didn't need to clean it. So then I moved to the SC connector on the launch fiber. And when we inspected that, we see that there's a little dot on here. So I went ahead and I gave it a click and I cleaned that and then inspected it again before I connected it to my OptiFiber Pro single mode port. Now, when it came to the LC connector end, it didn't look good at all. So that took a couple of clicks to get that end cleaned up. And I connected that to my bulkhead adapter. And then I inspected the LC connector on my tail fiber. I got that all hooked up. So now I've got my launch fiber connected to my tail fiber, my launch fiber connected to my OTDR. I'm ready to go in and start doing some testing and then setting compensation. So in this case, when we take a look at our test setup, we've got our auto OTDR. We are doing OS2 single mode fiber. We've got our test limit set to general fiber, and we're looking for a reflectance of less than negative 35, and we're going to be testing at 1310 and 1550. So I'm going to tap on that, and I'm going to come into edit. And what I want to make sure of is that I want to make sure that my launch compensation is turned off. I want to make sure that launch compensation is off. And you know what? I'm going to come into my test limit. We're going to go to more, and we're going to go to miscellaneous, and we're going to set our general fiber to a reflectance of less than or equal to negative 40, because that's what we would really like to see for UPC connectors with single mode fiber. So I'll hit save. I'll hit use selected, and now I'm going to run a test. And the reason I'm running a test is I want to see what the quality of those fibers look like. Now, the very first thing that I look for when I run this test is my port connection quality. And there is only one acceptable value for this, and that is green. If this is not green when we run this test, stop what you're doing, inspect that port, inspect the fiber. Because if that is not green, there is no sense going on. Any testing we do will be invalid. Now, in this case, what I do is I look at the loss between my launch and tail fibers. So this tells me that my launch between my launch and tail is 0.18 dB or decibels. That is within the range I'm looking for. When it comes to single mode fiber, I'm looking for a value that is less than or equal to 0.25 dB. That's fantastic. Now I can come over and I can take a look at the trace. And in this case, we can see that we've got our launch fiber right here. That looks good. We don't see any losses in the middle of our launch fiber. Here's the connection between the launch and the tail. And there is our tail fiber. And just like with the launch, everything looks good. There's no losses in there. So doing this test initially lets me know that my launch and my tail fibers are both good and the connection between them is good. So now I'll come back here. I'm going to hit home on my tester and I could save this. I could come in and say save this result. I'll hit save and I could go in here and I could call this launch fiber test. I'll hit done. And I'll hit save. Now, by doing that, by saving it, this is my way of proving to whoever's looking at the test results that my launch and tail fibers were good. So now I'll come back to the home screen again, and I'm going to tap on Set Compensation. Now in this case, I'm using a launch and a tail, which is the best combination. This allows me to do bidirectional averaging of my link, which helps me overcome differences in things like the backscatter coefficient between my launch fibers and the fiber I'm testing. Launch plus tail, whenever you can do it, is the best way to go. So I'll go ahead and hit set. So it is running that same test again, and it's measuring the loss and the length of my launch and tail fibers. So we'll see that we're almost done, and it came back. I could view the trace here. I would expect to see pretty much the same number that I saw when I ran the test. I'll go back and I'll hit save. It shows me that my launch fiber is 526 feet long. My tail fiber is 524. I'll go ahead and hit OK. Now here's the interesting thing. When I come into my test and I hit edit, we see that launch compensation is now turned on. So what this is telling me is that it will take into account I have a launch and a tail fiber, and it won't include those in the length and the loss measurements for the fiber I'm testing. So I am all ready to go. I have done my launch and tail compensation. I can come back to my home screen, and I'm ready to go in and test my OS2 single mode fiber using the general fiber limit and looking for connections to have a reflectance of less than or equal to negative 40 dB. So I hope this video was helpful for you. Be sure to check out our other videos and information about the training classes at ccttraining.com. If you have any questions about the class, give me a shout, and I would be happy to get answers for you.